US Abrams X tank versus Russian T-14 Armata tank. Experts suggest the T-14 is Russia's answer to the US-made M1 Abrams third-generation battle tanks. However, the US military could soon have a response to the T-14, as the next generation of Abrams main battle tanks has also arrived. General Dynamics Land Systems, GDLS, revealed its anticipated Abrams-X MBT prototype in AUSA 2022 Association of United States Army Defense Exhibition, which marks a deep modernization of the long-serving M1 Abrams tank, unveiled the new Abrams-X. Shortly after reports that Russia has deployed its T-14 Armata MBT in Ukraine. The T-14, Russia's latest MBT, claims to be a radical departure from the Soviet-era tank designs deployed in earlier phases of the ongoing conflict. Russia's T-14 Armata has been developed by UralVagonZavod, a subsidiary of the Russian state-owned defense conglomerate, Rostec. It was first unveiled at the Moscow Victory Day parade in May 2015. Similar to the T-14 Armata, the new Abrams-X also features an unmanned turret with an auto-loading ammunition system, and a reduced crew size, down from 4 to 3. The new Abrams is said to have the ability to team up with unmanned ground vehicles. Also, it features a hybrid powertrain which results in 50% fuel savings, according to claims made by General Dynamics. The hybrid system will also enable the Abrams-X to operate silently when stationary and possibly for short durations at low speed, which could be tactically advantageous on the battlefield. In addition, the T-14 is armed with an auto-loading 125mm 82-1M smoothbore gun that can fire anti-tank missiles. The T-14 weighs 48 tons, is significantly lighter than the M1A2 Abrams at 70 tons, and can reach speeds of 90 km per hour. It is also equipped with next-generation Malachite Explosive Reactive Armor, ERA, which can potentially defeat advanced anti-tank missiles. As the T-14's capabilities remain largely unknown, NATO may attempt to outmatch the T-14 with advanced tanks such as the US Abrams-X and German Panther Kf-51. But the return of large-scale industrialized wars of attrition, as seen in Ukraine, underscores the need for cheap and easily produced weapons that can be quickly supplied with fuel and ammunition. So, at the same time, the US has started production of its first light tank since the Vietnam War to improve protection, mobility and direct fire capabilities for infantry brigade combat teams. The 38-ton MPF is armed with a 105mm main gun and a 7.62mm machine gun. It shares the same fire control system with the M1 Abrams, and its chassis is based on the UK's IX reconnaissance vehicle. Reports indicate the US Army plans to take possession of its first MPF unit by 2025. The high costs of the Abrams-X, Kf-51 and T-14, their sensitive technologies are a strong disincentive for mass production and could make such tanks too valuable to risk in actual combat situations. Light tanks such as the US MPF may thus be more suitable for island defense operations. Their smaller size, weight and logistical requirements can allow them to be quickly transported across vast oceanic distances in sufficient numbers. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.